The loyalists now lie in ruins. However, amidst these ruins, new civilizations start to rise up to the unforgiving sun. From the rusted, radioactive derelict of the old world, new ergot states, both brave and wild, emerge to join the never-ending battle for the right to exist on the planet, mutilated beyond recognition by the flames of apocalypse.
Excited for this well before Early Access ever came out, before it was even on Steam, when it was still just on Kickstarter. And I played the original pre-alpha demo, and then the later first versions of the Steam Early Access release. But it's been about a year now, and I haven't really been back since some of the earlier versions, because I didn't want to, do everything before the first official release, which should be later this month. So they've been coming out consistently with a lot of really big updates, and I've been excited to come back to the game and take a look at it. So let's just make someone here. You know, I'm not really set on whether I want to do a... Because I've done a lot of male playthroughs, so it might be worth it to try a female playthrough. It's about Lana. You can change the name, as well as the history. But first, let me just come here. That's about my real life luck level. Yeah. Then attention. So we will have plus two personality with all male characters. And let's boost that. It's a very important skill in this game. Technology. And then money's good. Yeah, I'll feel confident about that. start off normal. And so this is a totally new interest in that. And I have never seen it yet, so let's take a look at what this says. So this
is Atom, a branch of the Soviet Army created long before the war, caused by the imperialist conquerors. Our mission does not end in gathering pre-war technology and reviving our Soviet motherland. We also strive to reach the pre-war quality of life for all. To realize those goals, we often send search expeditions into the wasteland. Not long ago, one of such expeditions, led by General Morozov, lost all contact with the base. Our human resources are limited. Therefore, the standard procedure is to send out but a few agents to investigate this problem. You are one of the chosen for this mission. General Morozov's troops had an important quest to locate, control, and study a secret bunker. Bunker 317. According to our data, it is located near the village Otradnoya. To successfully complete your mission, we recommend you to contact our agent in the city of Krasnoznemonye, codename Fidel. He's hiding in plain sight as a barkeep in the outskirts of the city, so apart from physical aid, he can offer you informational support as well. You will learn the password needed to contact our agent from the envelope. Destroy it upon reading. And remember, your mission is to gather intelligence on the disappearance of Morozov and his troops. No heroics. The wastes are a dangerous place. Good luck, cadet, and let there be Atom.
Now we have our mission and our objective set. And let's see. Sadly, we do get Rob as our intro. So all that good equipment we have is for nothing. Stops before you and rubs his hands as if to warm himself and to show you a formidable brass knuckle on his left hand. Or maybe you're like the little red riding hood delivering food to your sick grandmother in all these bags of yours. He whistles and, you are now being rubbed. This is intro cutscene number 3, letting us know that we have entered Otradnoye, or at least that we've made the walk there. before a sort of nicer playthrough this time. This character largely believes in rebuilding the wastes, but at the same time, she's trained, she's not naive. She'll kill and steal, but believes helping out the peasants and her society more. I think she would not sign up with the bandits when that time comes. And in general, I'm envisioning a sort of more noble playthrough than I would normally do. Imagining that she's a real ideologue for the Adam Project. Looking for someone. Went to ask her a couple questions. Troop of military types. So, we are obviously looking for General Morozov, who has gone to Bunker 317, and we've not heard back from him. So, I asked this man for the location of the ruins, because he said that he saw the military troops going in that direction. And instead of going there directly, because it's difficult, I'm going to then try to help out around and find my companion in Krasnoye Zemlya in order to deal with the bunker. See if they have any work here. The tech guy disappeared. God knows. We just disappear all the time. And then claim to be a millionaire. Any good rumors? Satanist Boy Scouts. But I'll see you later. Tries to nice guy me. And this is where the leader of the London comes. This is the gun dealer, that's the mechanic, and this is the bar, Hachevnia. If there's like an implicit yo, and I totally mispronounce that, it should be Hachevnia. Fuck you. Alright? Put the dots over the E. There is no reason those should just be implied. Guys, just hate foreign readers. Alright. Before you stands a plump, red-faced man, aged around 25. As you can see, he's aged exquisitely. Of course, in those times, it was much harder for a 16-year-old. So, he's talking about Morozov. Ask him about jobs. And he points me to his sister. He wants a business proposal. And he wants me to take a look at his book. And so I'll take it. We are looking for Lord of the Rings. The girl stops in her calculations and stares at him blankly. That's great. If ever you quite like it, it's a new recipe, you see. Not really. I forgot. Thank you. How did I break through? You see, my character just boofed pure Tom so that she could open up her brown eye. And this has led her to this intense decalcifying of the pineal gland. Mushrooms. You are General Morozov. Bound down, says the mushroom, and you faint. This reminds me of many moments. Alright. The bartender, swearing quietly, wipes the sweat from his brow. How are you feeling? She's strong, that one. Damn. What an idiot I am. Well, we're done it with the potion. Sorry, what a damn shame. I almost killed the girl. She gives us a smile. I watched over your things while you were out. Feel free to check. You have not been robbed. Miracles really do happen. Use my grandfather's recipe. So I think we actually just managed to get all our stuff back by tripping balls. Can I ask you some questions? There's a mailman, and there's Alexander. Oh dear. Well, I feel good about being that, so I'll talk to him. Get rich. Almost found our lost galleys when we saved them by getting out of this place because of it. Look at it, I'm also watching. Check out these meaty eyebrows. The real life people is what it is. Monster shaped into human form. Most of the villagers here are like that. Ugly fellas, and brittle dumb. We've got a new integrity, libertine lady, and official secret organization. It's not like they say in my native Georgia, a sweet peach, but that's still okay. They're not from Georgia, and he wasn't talking about the Georgia near Russia, as in he was talking about Georgia peaches, as in the Georgia just north of Maine. Let's see about that tech guy. shifty eyes. It's going to be government official before the war. The engine doesn't work. The tank was abducted. Oh, I need to get... going to go get a rusty knife. Which means I think we'll need a shot, which will be around here. I think it's around here. City of the South. In the north side, the children there are forced to wear radioactive hazmat suits and go out and pick for the corn in order to feed the elders of the tribes. And really, you know, it's a dazzling ritual to watch. It really brings home the Jacksonville spirit, but my god, is it bizarre. There you are. No, no harm done. I don't want to. Well, he gave me a rifle, so it's got a heart pierced by an arrow engraved on it. How sweet. Now let me rummage through his trash. Oh hell yeah, he's got some paper. Over here. I'm the trash boy now. Trash boy. Scarf and a piece of tire. This is the good stuff. That's what we've got here. We've got the good stuff. Now I remember you used to be able to cheat by editing the save files, but then they started encrypting them. Or at least they're no longer, I think they're binary files now or something. Anyway, let's go rob some graves. Cool. Now this reminds me of high school. Of that, definitely. Thank you. used to do that. Here in Jacksonville, we don't have to be an entomologist. We just have to really take our chances. You know, it's a hard time here. Hard times in Jacksonville. Let's go to the doctor. Thank you.
was the fish. Can I fish too? How's life? So, got fed up with all the people. He turns away. He chuckles mirthlessly. Turns back to you. I don't know how to put it. It's just that I believe that when people come together, they turn into a herd. It sounds like the solipsisms that Lenin was kissing us. Please, may I be smart enough to say this? I did. I see that you are no simpleton. You are also... I no longer view you as a slave beneath me in the Hegelian construct of the master and slave dialectic. You are now one of my equals, and I can respect your otherness. What can you tell me about the village? Interesting. I think I'll leave now. I've got to get this boy some booze, so he'll shut up about the whole existentialism. Seems like a real drag. Go out. Out dead. One shot. He needs some Sherman juice in his life. That's what that plan is. And that's... so close. He goes into town, but he lives outside. It's just like the witch. The bitch. Heard any rumors? Stash. as well as your thoughts. And you see he's got a photo of Stalker. There is obviously a heavy amount of influence from the likes of Andrei Tarkovsky, and as well as the game Stalker and Fallout games. All of the rumors that the bartender will actually tell you are basically just fourth wall breaking, you know, homages to the games that they were inspired by, as well as the movies and books. Ironically enough, not a lot of references to anything Metro related, which I thought was interesting. Basically, the bandits roaming around have a little man inside the village who's been helping them get truly fucked over. So, I'm listening. Yeah, a snitch. So, we're going to have to murder the rat. Interesting. Investigating. Agree. Work while they act like some sort of aristocracy. So you see the first sort of line here. This game makes very little attempt to conceal the fact that it is obliquely referring to the fall of the Soviet Union as this apocalyptic world where an oligarchy of disparate bandits become simultaneously still bandits, but they're more like feudal lords, and so they maintain both legitimate and illegitimate means of acquiring wealth and power and lord buff. And so the bandits seem to treat themselves as if they are the new government, and everyone everyone else treats them like they're bandits, and you realize in the end they're a bit like a feudal aristocracy, where they steal, rob, or collect taxes, what they call it protection money, and they demand loyalty. So you get a real sense that the society, its violent, jerky state, has still rebuilt itself to some sort of order. It's just genuinely a primeval, primordial, medieval, you know, sense of that order. So, let's go out and start investigating. And of course that's, you know, vaguely referencing the rise of oligarchs and the mafia and Russian power after the fall of Soviet Union. So, let's talk to this shifty guy. What a real mystery this was. Stocky, powerful man, aged around 30. As is everyone in this world, from face, impudent look in his eye, working slaps, rolling dice in his palm. Alright, so I'll play some dice, and I ask you some more questions. Tell me about yourself. Hunter. Representative in the village. You just come out swinging. Thieves are thieves, what's that to say? They survived, that's it. What if I want to join? Yeah, look. What if the one who's working in the village is just like the village plan? Making no trouble for you or anyone else. Out of sight, out of mind, as they say. Nothing against going over to that abandoned building, right? Listen, pal, two of my buddies are looking for a place to stay, just like I am. Thank you.
just go back to the doctor. That fight used to be substantially easier. And the weapons breaking is quite bad. I wasn't happy about that. That outcome. I'm Miss Noble. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. So I'm now going to try to infiltrate the bandits. Now, that might normally conflict with the whole idea of being a noble character, but I believe she has a strong sense of purpose with regards to this. So, let me see exactly what I've got. I've got 60 rubles. Let me see if I can get a discount from this boy. Alright, now that's an interesting proposal. I'd like to see your wares. Gunpowder, salt, rope. Do you want rope? Since the last couple times it doesn't really do much. I'm going to actually have to read up on how the crafting works now. Because it seems like it's substantially different. Like, things that I would think would be very useful are in fact incredible now. just because he finds it. So I think I'm gonna go with the pipe rifle. Rather than this airline respirator. That sounds pretty interesting. Custom made. I do not have that. I guess it's okay. I'm not overly. Let's see here. We've not found time. So if I fail that chance, by the way, that means that I basically just have to, I'm going to lose one of the materials. So is it not? Oh, 2x scrap. So it can't just be 1 scrap. Let me see if I sold any cheap scrap. There should be a safe in that basement that I won't be able to access yet. That's a nice new texture. Previously that was just bright green. Saying, quite the toy you must be, like Nutcracker. Where is your sword? And of course, if I came back here at a different time,
spots where you can actually plant crops. You know, as soon as you find some corn seeds, which they do have out here in the wilderness, the wastes. Time to have our meeting with the bandits. And with that, we are now on the world map, which is beautiful. It's now got fog to show you what you are aware of, but have not been to or are not seeing currently, as well as what you can currently foresee. This is new. This map has received a lot of updates since the last time I checked it out, but as always, you can walk over this large map, and you are now a much more reasonable representation of your character. Previously, you were much larger, and you would just walk on the squares. But now you're smaller, and you travel between it, and you can camp at any point, and it'll actually let you see that particular square and explore it. Let's meet these caravanners, see what they've got available for sale. Now, I've heard a rumor that luck actually contributes to what you can get from caravanners. Show me this stuff. He's got beets, he's got knives, some tobacco, very cheap. If you want to roll your own cigarettes, they got some more gunpowder, leather breastplate, and some wasp legs, which would allow you to go fishing. You also get a sweet troll, which will improve your dexterity and reduce hunger and adds health. What the hell? And this adds health, reduces hunger, increases virility. Doesn't work. You can plant the potato. That's interesting. I might actually want to check that out. But first, what kind of pistols does my gun use? You kind of need them. This would dramatically increase my health. I'm currently addicted to the potion. I'm sorry, I'm just dragging this out. Maybe instead of 4 rounds, I'll get 2. 14. Yeah. Let's sell the photo for 7. listen through. Now, let's go. I don't want to get caught here too long. We have to go keep our appointment with the bandits. Now, if I remember correctly... Normal looking waste dweller. Let's meet them. Let's see how normal they can be. This is new. So, Crescent knows the menu. We'll have to go there. We have to find Poker 317. Lord of the Rings. Fisherman. Oh, yeah. We eventually have to get some more supplies. Next year, so people know that it's still on tree bark. You just think on it. Let's see if he's gonna know. He's got corned meat. Delicious. Let's see. He's got a knife and a rusty knife. You have to be stupid enough to believe in that shit. Is there anything I can trade for that? Clues. I should go. You look normal. You look normal. You're boring. Now, there's probably gonna be some nasty shit in this cave. As tends to be the case. Oh shit, yeah, he's got a can of meat. He's thinking like I am. You gotta have your canned meat at all times. You don't want to die hungry and alone without your canned meat. Alright. What's in this box? Kinda sick. Bullshit. Alright. You found a brick. Your Antifa training has taken you this far. Awesome. Now, it seems like I just supported some sort of alt-right bullshit when I was just trying to be ironic. But people don't know me, so they can't tell that I'm being ironic. God damn it. Alright, let's get out of here. Now we have almost made it to the abandoned factory, and as we approach, let's take a look at what they have going for us. Alright, now remember, we are not going to participate in any legitimate activity. Probably. Not without some sort of character revelation first. Or the result will be fun. He leaves you cool. Friendly one will start. I have what I have. You have papers. Where else? Almost a legitimate force of the law. Chief Ari, if you talk to the Trade Council, Chris has them. We need them to properly recognize us as an official strike force in the region. Guarding the northern border, get it? So we won't have to loot the homes of nearby peasants. We will tax them, all proper-like. No punk will ever be able to join our mighty group then. I sure do love the wall. A girl with a criminal past is just what you need. All right. So how about that job? I won't think it's right. Tell me about yourself, Kasoy. I work for Dan. Tell me about Dan. Great guy. He's a great guy, you know. He is efficient. All right. Tell me about this place. You shouldn't think about it too much. It could bite you in the ass one day. Sure, we take our share from the profits of the local simpletons, but we spend that money to protect them. In these lands are so many freaks, mutants, and cold-blooded assholes crawling about that without our protection, those peasants would be dead already. If you say so. That's what you get for crawling around in toxic caves. One's there. As well as one there. And... survival is actually useful in this game, which I think is a nice addition. Technology as well. Let's get a little bit closer to the skills we need. Our weapons. Now, those in the North Bandits aiming about just doing their thing. Dumbo is right around here. There's one of his guards. Man in his 40s, it's such a chat. This is what I'm thinking of my character internally, but she's good enough at this line game. Well, how's the yurt? I thought there was a real blast. I'm gonna talk to Dan now. He's got a picture of himself right behind where he sits. This man's a maniac. Alright. So my test is to interrogate. So I've got to talk to Shisha. Now, how far will my character go to trick these bandits in the name of doing the greater good? Please make it be things. Come on. I just want to steal things. Is that so hard? Okay. Jesus. Alright. Let's talk to that guy. Alright, dance. Little piggy, what a fucker. Very patient. Very patient.
Shivering, look me in the eyes, you stupid fuck. Well, okay, so we're dealing with the maniac. He's nervous. Who is he? Schmuck from a treadmill. I see. He started talking about his money that he doesn't really have. Prisoner, shoot him in the leg. I mean, I knew it was not loaded. Probably. Fine, I'll go for a walk. I don't need your dick. I can make plenty of friends here. I can make friends with